Everybody, Simon Burton here with another episode of Assassin's Creed Odyssey. And situation still hasn't changed, as I'm still obviously recording instead of streaming this. As you can see, I've got some more resources. The best way to get your resources is going to the blacksmiths and just buying it from there. It does take up a bit of your drachma, but it's easier. We now have a new arrow called the Death Arrow. If you are doing the Daughters of Artemis quest, which is here, one of them, I think it's either the Nemean Lion or this is a picture I took of me killing the legendary animal here. So it's either this, I've forgotten what it's called, but it's basically a deer, so we'll just call it a deer. If you kill the legendary deer or you kill the Nemean lion, you will get the Death Arrow as a reward when you take it back to the Daughters of Artemis, all the way here in Focus. I've also killed quite a few more of the cultists of Cosmos, as you can see. And we've discovered one more of the sages of the Delian League because of it.
They may wake up first. Fine. Perikles welcomes you to his symposium.
So let's just carry on with the main story and let's see what we can get from Perikles' symposium.
Kassandra, it's you!
Phoebe!
You said you weren't coming back to Kefalonia, so I decided to leave too.
I said I wouldn't be coming back. But I don't remember saying you should leave.
Well, here I am!
How did you even get here, Phoebe?
Well, I did make some drachmi working for Marcos.
So you paid someone to bring you to Athens?
Not exactly.
Phoebe?
I needed a drachmi for when I arrived. I couldn't use it all to leave, and I didn't want to wait any longer. So I sneaked on a ship. Don't worry, nobody saw.
I just can't believe you made it.
I don't remember much of Athens from when I was a baby. But every once in a while, something feels familiar. It's nice.
I can't believe you're here.
Me either. I can't believe we both made it to Athens. It's so much different from Kefalonia.
But what are you doing here?
I'm here to get you ready. I have to make sure you leave all your weapons
and I'm here.
Change into these clothes.
So you somehow work here? For Perikles?
No, for Aspasia.
I don't understand why I have to change.
It's just what you do here. I felt weird at first, but you forget about it pretty fast.
And my weapons?
Don't worry, I'll take care of them. You don't want to scare people in there.
Well, how is it you're working for Aspasia?
Well, I did get into a little bit of trouble after I got to Athens. I may have been a leader of a small group of orphans that tried to cheat Aspasia. We didn't know it was her, though.
And you convinced her to hire you?
No. She asked me on her own.
That was lucky. I think I'm ready to go in.
You can't! Not like that, anyway. The Athenians like it best when you try to fit in. But don't worry, I have just the outfit for you.
I'll get changed. Promise you'll take care of my things?
Yep. Leave your weapons in the corner, and I'll come back when you're done.
Okay, so Phoebe that we met on Kefalonia is all the way here in Athens. That's pretty cool.
Uncomfortable in this.
Oh god, that just looks horrendous, that dress.
You say that like it's a good thing.
It is. If you want them to take you seriously, this is the easiest way. Trust me.
Is that everything?
You're all ready to go in. Don't worry. You've done scarier things than this.
I'm struggling to think of any right now. Are you sure I can't keep just one weapon with me?
No weapons. Now hurry and go in. Oh, and don't leave without saying bye.
If I have to fight someone unarmed, I'm gonna be so screwed.
Here, Kassandra. The mighty mercenary and traveler has finally made her grand entrance. Only slightly late, too.
Herodotus! Athenians have no problem letting me know when I'm not welcome. It's a relief to see your friendly face.
Don't let the company here tonight intimidate you.
I won't.
Pericles is no king. He needs these guests to love him, so that the people love him. And they, in turn, need Pericles. You're no different from any of them.
Do you really think these people will help me?
They will, if you get them to trust you. And you've wisely dressed for the occasion. Appearing trustworthy is the most important part of being trusted, after all. Now then, come, let me introduce you to everyone. They may not look it, but this group holds the way to the future on the tip of their opinionated tongue. Ah, Sophocles and Euripides, for example. Two of the most celebrated playwrights to date. No one can throw stones as far as they can. They appear to be locked in some kind of intellectual struggle, as is their way.
He's a writer of comedies, of all things. Comedies, Euripides.
I've heard of Sophocles. In my line of work, it pays to know who the richest and most famous men are.
Hermippus has also written his fair share of comedies. You should drink more. Lately, his attitudes have garnered him more notice than his works. However, the fellow beside him, Protagoras, is a sophist worthy of as much praise as the great Socrates himself.
Inviting Socrates seems like a good way to ruin everyone's night. I'm surprised they would let him in the door.
Oh, don't let Socrates get under your skin. At least he wore shoes for the occasion. And the poor thing gesticulating like an ape is Thrasymachos. If you listen closely, you'll notice he and Socrates are actually arguing the same points. But the wind from his wild gestures deafens him to critique.
That isn't at all what I mean.
Where is Pericles?
Oh, he never attends his own parties. Which reminds me, there's something I need to get his help with.
Vile Socrates! Always appearing where I least expect him. Warrior, protect me from his amorous gaze. Oh, Alcibiades, this is not a time for jealousy, but for love.
Let's not use Alcibiades as an example. Be good, and don't drink too much. So, tell me, what does a mystios like you think of a party like this?
This is going to be a long night. Party should be about vomiting up blood, not vomiting up poetry. These people are so clean.
If these guests aren't to your own unique tastes, then just focus on why you came here in the first place.
Thank you, Herodotus.
Now, if you'll excuse me, Pericles is here somewhere, and I need to prepare him. If he's alone, I'll tell him what your brother said.
Agreed. Pericles needs to know. I'll stay here and look for clues.
I hope they know something about your mother.
Me too.
Okay. So we've got to try and talk to some people and see if they know the whereabouts of Cassandra's mother. This is going to be fun.
this door or I'll kick it in.
Don't mind her. She likes to watch. Look at you. Such authority. Such aggression. I can see why Pericles has taken such an interest in you. Did you come to join us?
It sounded like someone was in pain.
Well, it can sometimes be hard to distinguish between sounds of pleasure and pain. Had I known you were going to knock, I would have left my door wide open for you.
I only came to this symposium to find someone.
Sounds like we can help each other then, doesn't it? You fetch us a bit of oil, I help you find who you're looking for. Maybe they're in here.
She's not in there.
I think I'll check all the same.
After your display earlier, it's probably safer I get the oil.
Obedient, too. I knew I liked you. Don't take too long.
Oh, that was something.
Just can't stay away, can you? Did you bring the oil?
When you walked in, you seemed like you and Socrates were...
How I wish you were right. One day, we will have that man in here with us. I promise you that.
I might be back.
If you come back with a jar of oil, I promise to show you how grateful I am.
This thing isn't telling me where I can get some oil, which is not good.
Just can't stay away, can you? Did you bring the oil?
You've grown up in Pericles' home, and yet you're so different.
No one is like Pericles, and he's only slightly more serious than usual, too. Athens is under siege, and he worries for her future. Which is why tonight is a fine time to celebrate what may be our last taste of freedom.
I might be back.
If you come back with a jar of oil...
Okay, it would be nice if it would show me where the hell the oil is.
Otherwise, do you need oil in that?
I need oil for a mission, but it's not showing me where the oil is, which is getting on my nerves. And Icarus is not available. Frick. Oh dear. Jar of oil, where would the jar of oil be? Found a jar of oil in ancient Greece, in the house of Pericles, where would I be?
There's much to do, and many unknowns on our horizon.
Thank you.
This is a very long loading screen. It's been going on for 5 minutes.
It's kind of what happens from time to time.
Of course, I only use the terms war or god or civility in the context of what can be observed. So I can observe soldiers fighting, but does that bring me any closer to understanding war? I haven't seen you around before, citizen. Perhaps you'd like to spare me conversing with this man of nonsense.
Sure, we can talk. What about?
Before Protagoras changed the subject, we were talking about the next Greek leader of Athens, Cleon.
I'll change the subject again. I'm looking for someone, a Spartan woman.
Spartan? Hopefully she's dead in the gutters. It's better than those mongrels deserve. I wonder if you found the woman, even if you saw her with your own eyes, would you believe her existence to be true?
This is getting nowhere. Forget it.
If you don't want to discuss that, then what?
If you're an ally of Cleon, why would Pericles invite you?
You're not from Athens, outsider. Here, we keep our enemies closest of all.
Come on!
Why isn't Aspasia here?
Can you be certain she isn't? To observe her presence is still no guarantee that she is here. In my opinion, it's just like her to cower in the shadows while we stand out here in the light.
This has been useless. Kere.
Yeah, let's try these two.
A new face in Pericles is aboard! That in itself is a remarkable thing. You must have seen me doing my impression of Cleon. I call it the Orange Ape.
I think I'm stuck in a loading screen.
You may have to close the door.
Did you just
yeah.
call me it?
What has that ever had happened to you?
Nope.
And so feisty too. Sometimes I wonder if I'm doomed to be the only young and
think about it, that's
here.
Think about it, what's
what
it called?
Call
Ubisoft has
Kassandra.
Never looked back on Assassin's Creed Freedom Grind, and they'll never
Kassandra.
Fix that bug, and then I can never progress.
I'm Aristophanes, and this man is Euripides. Oh, go on, introduce yourself.
I'm Euripides.
So I'm just gonna play some Save the World.
Not much for words.
Good men lead quiet lives, as old Euripides likes to say. Don't you, Euripides? Now, if you'll excuse us,
yeah.
I was just about to dazzle this old dog.
Hold on.
Okay.
Pericles. I call it the wooden board.
Yeah.
The man is your host.
Under every stone hides a politician, I always say. And Pericles is no different.
Well, he's clearly a douchebag. Whoever was one. And there we go, we've got the jar of oil. Figure now. Let's just hope this isn't gonna get too weird.
Just can't stay away, can you? Did you bring the oil?
I come bearing gifts.
We're saved! Today, these women grieved for their sons, and these men worked the war. But tonight, we forget all of that. Let's have some fun! What do you say? Care to join us?
No.
Now, it's time for you to help me, Ali. I'm looking for someone.
All business, right until the end. I like that.
Focus. I'm looking for a woman who fled Sparta a long, long time ago.
Fled Sparta? No one flees Sparta. But let's pretend she did. If she were stupid, she'd be dead. If
if she were smart, she'd do what Aspasia did. She'd earn her independence. The smartest and most resourceful women I've ever met have been in Corinthia.
Theatera? I've heard they play some sort of role in Corinth, but I assumed it was the same as any other city.
Oh, no. These women are unlike any other you'll meet. A force, and the only ones there with any smarts.
Ali! Come back inside!
Ooh, the celebration continues. When you reach Corinth, find Anthusa. No one goes in or out of the city without her knowing. Until we meet again.
Welcome back.
It's not much, but it's a start.
Okay, so
you think there's... Do you think there's ever gonna be an online feature in one of the Assassin's Creed games?
You mean like a sort of PvP thing?
Or maybe like where you can do the missions together.
They had that in Unity.
Did they?
Yeah.
Where you could play together with somebody else.
Yeah. There was actually a trophy called the Baguette Boy Band if you did a co-op mission with someone.
Is Unity one of the old ones?
Unity is on the PS4, set in France during the Civil War.
That ridiculous Xanthodontus exothalmic Morozov. But he doesn't talk without a drink.
I have no idea what that meant.
No, you don't.
Right, wanna hop on Fortnite, I get an invite.
He sounds more
impressive foreigner. Every Pivis is from Argos.
Alright.
I'm just like, let's hop on Fortnite. One second after. Invite. No invite.
Okay.
I do not like invite.
Wonderful. Now, if you want some friendly advice, Aristophanes cannot stand sweet wine. I've seen what it can do to him. Absolutely.
It just
wants
me to do this 34.
It wouldn't be a party without someone losing their stomach. I'll let you know if your plan worked. Say for that arrogant playwright. I don't see many distinguished guests in here. Can I help you with something? I'm here for your sweet wine. Yes, take it.
Don't
get out
that
of my kitchen. I'm very busy, you know.
I really hope this party isn't... Okay, good. It's fine.
It's come back for more.
Because the guy that I didn't join, he would probably be really, really, bad word. He would probably be really, really mad now if I didn't join him.
You and Aristophanes could both use a drink. Let's play a game.
A competition.
Ah, wonderful idea. Every Pivis seems quiet, but he never turns down a challenge.
Well, if you brought us some wine, I wouldn't be opposed to showing this young one how we Argives drink.
Let's conjure Dionysos, shall we?
This is pure swill.
Amateur. In my day, this would be considered nectar of the gods. Another round!
Ready for more?
Yeah, I can hardly stomach this pig's piss.
I could outdrink both of you with one hand. Let's have some more!
You ready for another?
What? I didn't know you could take the old damage from doing that.
Oh, I'm getting two ancient Greekmen pissed. This is gonna be fun. Ooh.
Myself. I'm on the trail of a woman who fled Sparta a long time ago.
Fled? Why?
She lost two children. She had no choice.
She fled to heal a broken heart.
Every Pythias, write her into a play.
I've heard.
It's funny how you have to make you want to make X puzzles. You need bacon to make X puzzles.
I'm not sure she'd trust priests.
Well. Power cells.
My friend Hippocrates, he's a physician, best of the best. He still keeps his office in Argos. If she went to him for help, there's no doubt he'd have given.
Oh no, no encampment.
I love getting drunk and singing.
No.
Come back if you want to sing with me.
I'll think about it. Hippocrates in Argos. Here I come.
Why do arms do this?
You can stop hiding in here. Everybody's won't notice you coming out. He won't notice anything.
Hiding? He thinks war has come to Athens. First they take our homes, then they take our heads. I intend to be found with at least my dignity intact. Or what's left of it anyway. If you see Pericles, tell him I said thank you for another colorful evening.
Yeah?
I think we agreed our use of that knowledge couldn't be more different.
Ah, you remember. Perhaps our conversation can continue.
You really intend to use this young destruction to avoid the point being argued?
You have been arguing a single point all night and no one has a black eye? You have my attention.
We're discussing the nature of runes. We're better to do so than here. I'll ask you the same question I asked.
No.
Would you agree that the act of ruling is an art?
It is an art, as all worthy undertakings are. That is not up for argument.
Yet, medicine is for the benefit of the people.
I'll be back.
Okay.
Carpentry improves the building, not the building. Then, is the art of ruling not for the betterment of the ruled rather than the ruler?
Don't be absurd!
This argument between you two is pointless.
Perhaps. How do you define art?
I'm not getting dragged into this.
Very well. Answer this. Does the artist not give form and symmetry to her subject?
Well, yes.
Laws and justice do much the same for people. They not? And is there any better way to communicate the story of a people than by revealing its customs and laws? If yes, then ruling, and thus justice, must be an art, as Thrasymachos says.
If you say so.
Aspasia.
Guess I'm not Aspasia.
You shouldn't be too hard on Socrates. He really has a brilliant mind. Even if he comes off a little strong. He isn't always like that, is he? Ah, Phoebe. Pericles has retired to the balcony already, has he? His ability to sneak off and sulk is second to none.
I can go get him, and Kassandra can help. Everyone listens when she talks.
That'll be fine. Run along. Kassandra will be right behind you. Now, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Aspasia. I had to go to great lengths to cover up your work in Megaris. have been watching me. I knew you people couldn't be trusted.
We do what we must to survive, and there's no shame in that. It's how you got here, how I got here. The clothes, they fit you well, I trust.
These may be the nicest clothes I've ever worn, but I feel a bit uncomfortable, to be honest.
You never really get used to them. It seems we have the attention of the entire room without a single eye being fixed on us. If you'd like to talk, do it now. Do it discreetly.
I've been searching for a woman named Miri, my mother.
Come back.
Welcome back.
And my search brought me here.
What clues do you have to her whereabouts?
A physician named Hippocrates may have seen her in Argos.
He's a good man. If you find a woman named Agathi there, do let her know Aspasia sends her regards. What else?
Alcibiades gave the name of a woman in Corinth.
I'm sure he did. My dear friend, Anthusa,
this is crystal.
Enjoyed a life in Corinth through legitimate means. Mostly legitimate, anyway.
That's all I have.
There is another option. In a former life, when I needed something done or someone found, I contacted a friend. An admiral of a sort.
What's his name?
Her name is Xenia. When we last spoke, she was in chaos. A word of caution. When you go to her, be on your guard. Sea life makes a monster out of most people.
Thank you, Aspasia.
When you're done, return here. Together, we will find who you're looking for. Now do me a favor and get Pericles to come down here.
Kassandra!
I didn't send for you. No matter how you've dressed for my party, Phoebe shouldn't have let you in.
Aspasia told me to come find you. She wants you to come down to the party.
She says I don't interact with our guests enough. But these parties aren't for me. Technically, you're a guest. If you join Herodotus and me, that should be enough for her, don't you think?
You really don't want to go downstairs, do you?
When your days are spent speaking in front of crowds, you begin to crave these moments of silence.
Or as silent as I let it be, at least.
Your life is in danger.
Yes, yes, Herodotus was saying. This cult doesn't worry me. I have my life threatened by far worse people every day. My true concern is Athens. I fear for her future.
The Spartans aren't your real concern, Pericles. The cult is coming. And they're bringing their strongest weapon.
Listen to her, Pericles.
The Spartans are immediate. A cult's threat is ambiguous.
I'm related to one of the cult members. And I believe him when he says they're coming after you.
Sound counsel to consider. I'll be sure to let my men know, regardless.
Aspasia sent me to see what's taking you so long.
Tell Aspasia I'll be right there. I suppose this is where our conversation ends. Thank you again for helping me. I hope my guests are able to help you in your search.
Time will tell.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay, time to leave this bloody symposium. Oh, bloody time. I don't feel right without having my weapons on me.
You look tired.
Only of conversation. I think that's the most talking I've ever done.
See? You didn't need the weapon after all. Are you leaving?
I've had enough Athenian hospitality to last me a lifetime.
You get used to it. It's nice. What are you going to do now?
There's a woman on the island of Chaos that I need to meet. I think I'll head there first.
I've heard there are pirates there.
I'll be sure to be careful.
Good. Before you go, I heard something from Aspasia about Kefalonia.
What is it?
She said there was some sort of plague. You don't think... My friend, the blood fever.
Don't think like that. Whatever happened on Kefalonia isn't our fault. I'll go myself and find out if this plague even happened, okay?
Okay. Thanks. I knew I could count on you.
You still there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
I'm happy here. And this isn't Kefalonia. That means you'll be back.
That's very true.
She says she has a mission for me.
I'll see you soon, Phoebe.
Bye, Kassandra.
Oh, now the last one. Oh, hello. So, now I can do a few things. I can either go to...
I've always thought that all of the new Assassin's Creed games, like... The three newest Assassin's Creed games... Wait, hold on. I mean, the two newest Assassin's Creed games. I think they're the best.
Odyssey is really good. Origins... storyline kind of got a bit boring. Anyway, so let's see, I can either go to Argos, I can go to Corinthia, or I can go to Chios. Let's see which one's closer. To pull up my map. Chios is actually much, much closer. Somewhere just across the river. Corinthia is just down here. And Argos, as an Argolis, not far from Corinthia. Okay, I say we do it the easy way and... we go to Chios.